In light of the decision taken by the CARICOM heads to pursue reparations for transatlantic slave trade, Caribbean slavery and native genocide Rastafarians met to discuss the issue. Members of the Caribbean Rastafarian Organization say that they will not sit idly by and watch all others collect accolades and leave Rastafarians behind.
One of the calls which really came out of that meeting was the need for Rastafari to seek an apology from our politicians. The reason, as you know, Rastafari has always been agitating for reparations, repatriation over the years. Whenever we bring up the issue, we were ridiculed. We were sometimes even harassed by some of those very same politicians who today we see embracing the subject.
The Caribbean Rastafarian Organization says that letters will be written to CARICOM leaders to include Rastas on the Reparations Commission.
At the St. Vincent Reparations Conference, the role of Rastafari was acknowledged. The contribution Rastafari has made was acknowledged. But we are of the view that the politicians feel that Rastafari has taken it thus far. Now is that the turn for them to take the baton and run with it, even leaving the Rastafari behind.
We are going to have to share our thoughts through the other islands that were not here. We need to have more discussion and educational type programs on what reparations is really about. So we're going to try and encourage our brothers and sisters around the CARICOM region in the civil society organizations to get a better understanding of what the issue of reparations really is all about.
CARICOM is launching an effort to seek compensation for what the regional integration movement says is the lingering legacy of the Atlantic slave trade across the region. CARICOM has enlisted the help of a prominent British human rights law firm and is creating a reparations commission to press the issue. Reporting for the DBS News World, I am Cecile Actille.